Let's today look at a function that many of you might not be using at all, but I think it's very important to learn it because it helps you a lot when you have got a lot of formula that can give you errors. So the function is called ISERROR, and the syntax goes like equal to ISERROR and the parent star, the function, and the parent close. So as the definition itself suggests, it's returning the logical value as true if the value refers to any error value such as #NA, #value, #ref, #div, num, name, or null. Otherwise, it returns a false value. So remember, friends, ISERROR by itself will only give you a true or a false statement. So let's see how it can be used in our day-to-day work. But first, if you're not already, please make sure to subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon for regular updates on new videos. So as I said earlier, the ISERROR is a logical function and it just returns a true or a false value. Let's see first how it gives us the true or the false value with a small example. Now let's say I've got this database where I have the date of birth, then I need to calculate the age and days as of today, and then of course I'll use the ISERROR function. Now first of all, if you look at the date here, some of the dates are incorrect. What I mean to say is that there's some typo in those dates because of which they're not in the correct format, like here the second one and of course the last one, they've got typos. So in order to calculate the date, I will subtract the date of birth from today. So what I'll do is that I'll do equal to today minus the date of birth and enter. So this will give me the age in days. I'll just copy this function and paste in the entire array. Now you can see that in two of the cases, I've got an error because these are actually not in the date format and these are in text format. So what I'll do is that I'll use the ISERROR function. So what I'll do is that here in this particular cell, I'll put down equal to ISERROR parent start. I'll reference D26 parent close and enter. I'll just copy this cell and paste it in the entire array. And yes, you can see that in two of the cases where there's an error, it gives me a logical true. And there's no error, it gives me a false. So this is how exactly ISERROR function works. But obviously, I can understand that in day-to-day use, you do not want the logical true or the false. And actually, you would want those true and false values to determine something, to give you some value. So what we'll do is that we will try to use this ISERROR function in conjunction or along with the if function. So it'll become if ISERROR and then true or false. For both true and false values, we'll have something, which essentially means that it's not just a logical function, but against the true or the false logics, we are also taking certain actions. So now if we have to use ISERROR along with if, let's look at the syntax. It goes like equal to if parent start is error, then in the parents we put down the function, comma, the true value, and comma, the false value, parent close. And also is error when used with if can define what your true and the false conditions should be, as we already discussed. Now let's look at the same example that we've seen earlier, and this time let's just try to use if and ISERROR together. So here was the date, here was the age and dates. Some of them had errors because the date format was not correct, and then with ISERROR we got a true and a false. Now we'll use it along with if. So the function goes like equal to if bracket start ISERROR, then we'll put down this one, comma. Let's say, what do you want to do if it is an error? I just want to leave it as a blank cell. So the blank cell is denoted by two double quotes, comma. What else do you want to do? If it's not an error, then I want to display the date. Parent close and enter. I'll just copy it and paste it in the entire array. See, now we have got values in only the ones where there are no errors. Otherwise, it's a blank cell. Now, we'll remove the reference in this particular cell, in this particular functions, to the cell E8. So, we'll just copy the function in E8 entirely and paste it over here. So, E8 has to be replaced with the function in E8, paste it over here and enter. And now I'll just copy this cell again and paste it down. Now you can see that even if this entire thing is kind of deleted, your function still remains the same and it is not affected by what is there in E and F. Now what you can also do is that instead of a blank cell here, wherever there's an error, you can put down a user message saying that please check the date format or something else like that. And then those particular cells, you can do conditional formatting to kind of change the color. Let's say you change the color of that particular cell that has the message to red. So what you simply need to do is that you need to just change the function here, the true value, which we had put in double quotes, and in the quotes you just put down, please check the date of birth, format, and enter. I'll just copy this cell again and paste it over here. This is really helpful when you've got long Excel sheets and they have a lot of such errors which you copied from a lot of places. It'll help you in actually looking at your data correctly and finding out wherever the typos are, and any particular errors that you find in calculations can be removed by using these functions. You can then also kind of filter those particular cells. You can filter those rows and just look at those cells that have those problems and kind of resolve them separately.